The REvil decryption key is obtained. Windows and Linux are vulnerable to privilege escalation attacks, and the Pegasus Project reveals phone spyware targeting. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings! I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for July 27, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. We have a bunch of ransomware and malware news to get into, and I've been gone for 2 weeks. So, on to the news. Let's go ahead and start with REvil. So, Cassaya is a remote management software company who was recently under fire due to a vulnerability in their product that's allowed cyber criminals to hit 1,500 organizations with ransomware. Cassaya had a flaw in their customer service portal, which is called the Cassaya Virtual Systems Administrator, that remained vulnerable to data leaks for 6 years, and it was tracked as 2015 CVE-2015-2862, a directory traversal vulnerability. Another security issue that allows for the vulnerability in Cassaya's VSA was tracked as CVE-2021-30116, and that one was assigned on April 2nd. So the attack happened over 4th of July weekend to Cassaya. That means that Cassaya had known about this since April, not including that earlier flaw from 2015, giving attackers plenty of time to exploit it. So according to Cassaya, the online customer portal is deprecated, and that's why it was never patched for the 2015 issue, but it unfortunately stayed online. After the attack happened earlier this month, Cassaya did take the portal offline. Now REvil is the ransomware and the group behind this attack, demanding $70 million for a universal decryptor or smaller sums from each victim separately. Strangely though, REvil went silent and they shut down their payment infrastructure soon after their demands, and an unnamed third party sent Cassaya a universal decryptor key for the REvil ransomware. Now, Cassaya was recommended not to pay the ransom by multiple parties that they discussed this with, and they would not confirm or deny if they paid that $70 million to get the key. Given recent discussions between Biden's White House and the Russian government, including Biden pressuring Putin to disrupt ransomware groups within Russia's borders, it is possible that REvil was asked to disappear for a while as a gesture of goodwill from Putin, but this is unclear. The US government has not commented on any potential activities at this time. Companies affected have a master key to decrypt their ransom machines now, but they still could run the risk of REvil using any potentially stolen data to exploit them further. Microsoft's Windows 10 is vulnerable to a zero-day tracked as CVE-2021-36934. This is dubbed Serious Sam, and this vulnerability could allow an attacker to gain admin rights and execute arbitrary code using system privileges on a system. Now, this was disclosed publicly via Twitter by a user named @JonasLYK, and it has not been patched, but Microsoft is now sharing a workaround. This issue affects client and server-side versions of Windows 10 since October of 2018, and while not officially released yet, Windows 11 does appear to also be impacted. According to a Microsoft security advisory, the elevation of privilege vulnerability exists because of overly permissive access control lists on multiple system files, including the Security Accounts Manager database, which is called SAM or SAM for short, hence the nickname for the flaw. This could allow an attacker to then install programs or view or change or delete data, or they could even create new accounts with full user rights. The attacker would need to have the ability to execute code on the system, on the victim system, in order to exploit this flaw. Now, all of the databases impacted are found under the System32 config directory. An attacker could steal NTLM hashed passwords to escalate their user privileges via a pass the hash attack, and the files could be accessed using shadow volume copies, since they would not be directly accessible as they are always in use by the operating system. So while we wait for a patch, because we can assume that one will be coming, Microsoft's temporary workaround is to restrict access to the directory and delete the volume shadow copy service. The workaround can be set up via the command prompt or PowerShell, and I have links included which include both of those commands. And these shadow copies are sometimes used to restore data, so be aware that removing the copies could impact data restoration processes. We will likely see an update from Microsoft with a patch very soon, possibly within a few days if not already posted after the recording and the writing of this segment. Now, I also wanted to mention Sequoia, which is completely separate. This is another privilege escalation issue, but this one is found in Linux. So this issue is tracked as CVE-2021-33909, and it affects default installations of Ubuntu 20.04, 20.10, 21.04, Debian 11, and Fedora 34 workstation, along with Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6, 7, and 8. Now, this could be exploited by a malicious user with malware that is already dropped on a vulnerable machine. Sequoia comes from the Linux kernel's sequence file interface and a size T2 to int type conversion vulnerability. This could allow an attacker locally to edit or delete a deep directory structure, resulting in a privilege escalation. Mitigation techniques are available via the Qualys blog, and they include a ton of information on Sequoia, and the patches will be rolling out from Linux distros in the meantime. Big shout out to my Hush Puppy perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. We got a new one this week and we have a new one next week, so I'm so excited. Thank you so much for the fur baby photos. And I also wanted to send a quick shout out to Nyx, Fred C, Logan A, Roshjamoft, hopefully I said that right, William D, I am Karno Chan, Razor, and CM Hedrick for joining the ThreatWire Alliance, and as always for supporting the show. Check out the Patreon Alliance for your exclusive access to an audio-only podcast version of this show. And on to the third news story. In an article by the Washington Post, an investigation showed that more than 50,000 phone numbers for activists, journalists, business execs, and politicians were possibly targeted by the Pegasus malware, both on iPhone and Android. This matches up with a data leak from the Israeli-based NSO group showing that their Pegasus malware is being used to target activists using all sorts of exploits, including one that's a zero-click, zero-day in iOS. A group of journalists made allegations against NSO Group, calling their report the Pegasus Project, wherein they examined the data that was leaked and found the firm was storing a cache of those 50,000 numbers. They are allegedly selling the Pegasus malware used as a spy tool to governments and other third parties who could then use it to infect dissidents. NSO Group denied all of the allegations. Obviously they would. According to WaPo, 37 smartphones were confirmed and tested to be targeted and successfully hacked, and all of those appeared on this list. They also mentioned that it's unknown who made this list or why, and it's unknown how many total from this list were targeted and surveilled as well. Now, the alleged list does not include names, but reporters were able to ID numbers as belonging to many people, including 600 politicians or government officials, 85 human rights activists, 189 journalists, and 65 business executives. Targets would be hacked if they, for example, visited a site and they were redirected to an auto download of the spyware, which could occur if an attacker intercepted web traffic going to their phone. This could also be done using cell phone tower clones or devices installed on their ISP. In response, Amazon deactivated NSO Group's AWS cloud computing accounts after Amnesty International discovered Pegasus malware was using AWS to operate via CloudFront, which is a part of AWS, and this was confirmed by Citizen Lab researchers. While Apple did recently drop a slew of updates after the fact in their most recent patch, which is version 14.7 for iOS and iPadOS, that does not include any patch for Pegasus. No additional patches for vulnerabilities contributing to that Pegasus malware are currently available at this time. So I have never mentioned it on ThreatWire, but I also run this Sailor Moon YouTube channel, and I figured I would tell you about it real quick. Y'all know that I love that anime so much. So this is like a little side hobby that I've been doing for a few years. It's called Sailor Snubs. You can find it on YouTube. And if you are into more of that lighthearted merchandise reviews about anime and you want to see like my weeb otaku side, because I do have that kind of side to myself. Check it out and subscribe. It's youtube.com/sailorsnubs. And with that, do not forget to like and subscribe to this channel as well. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.